Hi everyone, welcome back to the SAM biology classes online. I am Salim. Today we are going to study another important concept of zoology, that is key characteristics of Ascaris. We know that Ascaris, it is commonly called roundworm and it belongs to the phylum Aschelminthes. It is also called Nematihelminthes. And in this video, we are going to cover the important key characteristic features of Ascaris lumbricoides. So Ascaris, it is commonly called a roundworm. It is a endoparasite and found in a small intestine of the man. You know that endoparasite means the parasite which live inside the body. So particularly it lives inside the body in the small intestine of man. Then second important feature is the body of Ascaris is long, cylindrical, and it is pointed at both the ends. Long, cylindrical, and pointed at both the ends. You can see this diagram. Okay, so in this diagram you can see that this is a male Ascaris. Okay, A1 is male Ascaris and B is female Ascaris. So you can see that the body is very long and it is cylindrical and it is pointed at both the ends. Both the ends of the Ascaris, male and female, are very pointed. Okay, I hope you understood the second point. Long, cylindrical, and it is pointed at both the ends. The body of Ascaris, it is covered by cuticle. Okay, the body is usually, we know that our body is covered by epidermis. Above the epidermis, same way in Ascaris, epidermis is covered by cuticle. And cuticle, it is a layer present above the epidermis. It protect the Ascaris from the host digestive enzymes. As I told you, it is an endoparasite. It is live inside the small intestine particularly, and therefore we know that in the small intestine many type of digestive juices containing digestive enzymes are secreted. Therefore this Ascaris get protected by the presence of cuticle. So cuticle, remember, it is a layer present above the skin and it protect it from the host digestive enzymes. Then the adhesive organs are entirely absent, and if they are entirely absent, as you know that in the Platyhelminthes, suckers and hooks are adhesive organs. These suckers and hooks are absent in the Ascaris. They are totally lacking, and due to the absence of adhesive organs, it is compensated by very poor locomotion. So very poor locomotion is observed in the Ascaris. The locomotion by the Ascaris is very poor inside the intestine, and adhesive organs are also entirely absent, and cilia is also lacking. So cilia, you know that these are the hair like structures, so they are also absent. And animal alimentary canal, coming to the digestive system, we know that digestive system mainly has alimentary canal. The alimentary canal of Ascaris is very simple, and it get digested food from the host body. So it get the ready-made food or completely digested food from the intestine. Therefore the alimentary canal of Ascaris is very simple. The next, the presence of muscular pharynx. So in the general characters you studied that the development of muscles in animals was first time it was seen in Aschelminthes. And the pharynx is highly muscular. It is made up of different types of muscles, and this muscular pharynx helps in ingestion of food. Ingestion means intake of food, and it was done by sucking action. So you can see that the muscular pharynx will suck the digested food from the host, and therefore it act as a organ of ingestion in the Ascaris. Ingestion means intake. of food. It was done by the sucking action. Then circulatory system is absent, and therefore it is compensated by the presence of pseudocoelomic fluid. So the body of Ascaris in which the pseudocoelomic fluid is present, and this pseudocoelomic fluid helps in absorption, transportation of food, oxygen, and it also helps in removal of waste from the body. So this pseudocoelomic fluid, it performs three functions. One is it helps in absorption of food, and also transportation of food, and transportation of oxygen, nothing but exchange of oxygen, and also it also helps in removal of waste from the body. I hope you understood this point. Now, the anaerobic respiration. So the Ascaris has the capacity to survive in intestine even in the absence of oxygen. So we know that intestine is free from oxygen. So oxygen is not available in the intestine of man. So in this condition also, it can respire due to the anaerobic respiration capacity. So what is anaerobic respiration? The respiration takes place in absence of oxygen is called anaerobic respiration, and the Ascaris shows anaerobic respiration, therefore it can survive in intestine. And sense organs are also entirely absent in the Ascaris, because these sense organs are not needed as it get digested from food from the host, and also it is protected from the predator. Therefore, no need of sense organs. So, sense organs are entirely absent. So, the Ascaris, female Ascaris, it produces a very large number of eggs. So, you can see that it produces 162 eggs per minute. So, per minute, a female Ascaris produces 162 eggs. You can see that 2,34,000 per day. So if you calculate, so very large number of eggs are produced by the Ascaris. So almost 2,34,000 eggs are produced per day. So it has very huge power of producing the eggs. And these eggs are covered by a hard shell. So the eggs of Ascaris are covered by hard shell in order to give protection to the eggs. And the eggs, one more quality of eggs is these eggs are very smaller in size. Hence, so it helps in the easier dispersal of these eggs in different places. Then the mode of infection, if you look at the mode of infection, it is direct. No intermediate host is required. So as I told you, the life cycle of Ascaris, it involves only one host. Therefore, it is called monogenetic life cycle. What is monogenetic life cycle? When the life cycle is completed in only one host, it is called monogenetic condition. Example, Ascaris. So it does not require any intermediate host, or secondary host is not required. Only one host is present, that is man. And the mode of infection is direct. For example, you know that in Plasmodium, if you take example of Plasmodium parasite, the female Anopheles mosquito helps in transmission of parasite from one person to another person. So it requires the intermediate host or vector. But the Ascaris, it do not require any intermediate host. So the mode of infection is direct. I hope you understood. And lastly, the disease caused by Ascaris is called ascariasis. The disease caused by Ascaris is called ascariasis. So these are all about the important key characteristics of Ascaris. If you understood, like the video, subscribe the channel, and hit the bell icon all to get all the latest notification of our channel. Thank you very much.